Hello students, let's we start our next topic, that is theory of evolution. According to this theory, first living material, that is protoplasm, has been formed in ocean. And how formed this protoplasm? By organic compound and inorganic compound. In due to course of time, unicellular organism was formed. That time only one cell organism was formed, and gradually changes occurred in the unicellular organisms, from which larger and more complex organisms were formed. Means that is multicellular organism were formed. All those changes were slow and gradual. That changes are not fast changes, that is slow and gradual, means step by step that changes are occur there. Duration of all these changes is at most 300 crore years. Changes and development in living organisms had been all round and multidimensional, and this led to evolution of different types of organisms. Hence, this overall process is called as evolution, which is organizational. Means, here we have given the information that changes and development in living organism had been all round and multidimensional. Not in any only one way that changes are occur or development is occur, but all round that changes are occur, and that is step by step. That is called organizational. Progressive development of plants and animals from the ancestors having different structural and functional organization is called evolution. This development is occur progressive development. Step by step, that all the changes are added in the that species or in living organisms. From their ancestor to the offspring, and functional organization is occur there. Structure, that is also different structures that also develop, and functions also develop in that organisms. And overall development is occur there, and that is called evolution. Next point we have given there, evidences of evolution. Collective thinking upon all above mentioned theories implies that evolution is everlasting process of changes. However, it needs proof to prove it. Following are various proof available in support of the theories mentioned above. First evidence we have given, that is morphological evidences. Here activity we have given, small activity, that is observe the following images and note the similarities between given animal images and plant images. Here we have given some plant animal images and plant images. We have to observe it carefully and to tell similarities between all animals and all plants. So various similarities like structure of mouth, position of eyes, structure of nostril and ear pinnae, and thickly distributed hairs on body are seen in animals. So when we observe these animals, so all animals mouth position is similar. Structure of nostril, that is also similar. And the ear pinnae, that is also showing similarities, as well as thickly distributed hairs on their body that also look like similar. Whereas similarities in characters like leaf shape here, leaf venation and leaf petioles etc. occur in case of plants. These indicate that there are some similarities in those groups, and hence it proves that their origin must be same and must have common ancestor, and that we have given the morphological evidences. Morphological evidences means outer look of that living organism, means animals and plants. If they are showing similarities, from that we can say that their ancestor is same. And that scientists, we have given the evidence of these morphological evidences.